Hi, welcome to Barney Tech Channel. Here we are going to see low forward power production. Its ANSI code is 37. Now we will see the causes of low forward power production. First cause, if the generator trip by class B trip, then the problem may be due to turbine and few generator production which is under class B tripping. According to class B tripping, it will trip the turbine first, or turbine is intertripped by closing the ESVS. In this condition, generator CB is still connected with the grid. So in this case, the power from the grid will start to flow into generator. If it become below very low power and after using maximum stream from turbine, during this time the relay sends low forward power. Second, in some case, if the excitation to generator is over or under, then the generator start to inject more VAR into the system. Actually, the generator will not produce the VAR, it only have the voltage at the load end. Depend on load and excitation level, the VAR is produced. In this case, we will see little deeper with the capability curve. This is not actual curve, just consider it. Over this curve, only this area generator produce good efficiency. Let us consider, if the generator excitation is very high, during that time, if you see, the watt is very low. Due to this also, we get low forward power tripping. Third, in some case, if the generator run in low load condition, even home load also not get utilized from the generator. In this condition, if the generator run below no load loss, then in the point of running cost, it is loss only. So it is better to trip the generator. Now we go to the effect of low forward power. In few case, it produces overspeed to the turbine. Since the rotating and speed control are mechanical, they are not able to reduce the speed suddenly. And also, the rotating part are designed for some maximum inertia only. If it rise more than that, it may affect the mechanical parts. In some other case, it lead to motor action. When the turbine is not having sufficient stream to produce power or turbine trip, then the power from the grid will start to flow towards the generator and it will lead to motor action. Next, we will see how to prevent the low forward power. We have to maintain the generator load above 5% and maintain proper excitation of the system. Now we will see how to test low forward production. Let us consider the generator is 138 MVA, voltage rating is 25 kV, and VT ratio is 25 kVA/110 V. The full load current of the generator is 3187 amps, and the CT ratio is 5000/1 amps. Now we will see the relay settings. In relay settings, we have to note two things. One is power. It is in SP percentage, which is 5%. Second one is trip time, which is 5.4 second here. In this also, we can able to use two stages if we need. It is SB percentage we have noted here. This SB, we have to make this our generator power in relay settings. From there, it will take 5% as per our settings. It is 5%. Now we go for calculation. We all know that formula for power is V into I into 1.732 into cos theta, where the value of cos theta is 1. The generator power is 138 MW. As per relay setting, it is 5%. So we have to multiply by 5% with generator power. 5% is nothing but 0.05, and we get 6.9 MW. We have to equate this 6.9 megawatt into this power formula. As per the low forward power mainly occurs with low current. So here we are going to keep voltage constant, that is 25 kV. In this formula, I am going to keep current on one side, remaining all on other side, which is will go to denominator. When I substitute all the value, I got 159.35 amps. The value which I got is primary current, but for testing of this function, we need to inject secondary value. So now I am going to find the secondary current, and the CT ratio is 5000/1. The formula to find the secondary current is primary current by CT ratio. The secondary current is 159.35 amps divided by 5000. We got 0.03187 amps. For kit, we have to inject 63.5 volt and 0.03187 amps, that is 31.87 milliamps. We have to inject into the relay and you have to wait until the trip time which you have set to the relay. Now we will go for the production trip configuration. For low forward production trip, it will trip all the CB. On next video, I am planning to make reverse power production. We came to the end of this section. See you on next video. If you like this section, then please share to your friends and colleagues. Take care and bye from Barney Tech channel. Thank you for watching this video.